Well, hello everyone. It's Joni back again with another meditation. So we're back indoors today. A little bit of snow outside, a little cool. So it was guided to come in here, and the angel in the background. So we're just gonna close our eyes, and we're gonna start off with taking a few deep breaths, breathing in for a count of four through your nose. And holding it, and then releasing through your mouth, letting everything go. And again, breathing in through your nose, and holding on to it, and releasing everything else. And this time we're going to breathe in again for a count of four. We're going to hold on to it and become one with it, and then send that energy back out. So breathe in. Hold on to that new energy, becoming one with it, and then send it back out. And just breathe normally now. Focusing on your breath, how it's always there for you. I want you to release any other thoughts or feelings or concerns that you came here with. Just imagine a beautiful angel entering the scene, and just put your concerns you don't need right now on that angel's back, on her wings, and then just watch her magically leave the scene and carry those concerns away up to the heavens, and trust that she will take care of them. Bring him back to the light, back to love. And then bring your focus back on your natural breath, your natural breathing, noticing how it's always done for you. You don't have to control anything. At this time, I'm going to call upon all of our angels to be with us, our highest angels, highest spirit guides, our guardian angels, archangels, ascended masters, our ancestors, as well as the nature spirits, all to be with us now. Just imagine beautiful, loving beings entering the room. And watch them come and stand behind you. And in between us, connecting us, connecting our hands in a great big circle. And just open up to them, knowing that they are trustworthy. And just continue to release anything you need to release right now. Letting go of attachments. Letting go of judgments. Letting go of your beliefs, your views on things, any kind of separation. Just work on letting those go. Allow those angels to take care of all of that for you. Give them all up to them. In exchange for healing, unconditional love and light, acceptance. And just allow this transmission of energy to take place, releasing fears and blocks in exchange for love and light. Take a big deep breath. Breathing in this new energy, becoming one with it, and releasing everything else. Feel those shivers as an indication of all the work you're doing. And just trust that the work is going on deep levels. Yourself to start to feel lighter, releasing more and more, and allow your spiritual body to float higher and higher into the air, and just go with it, trusting the process, knowing you will be brought to where you need to be. Feel your angels around you still, all of us still together in a circle, but we're up in the air, floating, symbolically. Feeling lighter. The more we let go, the higher we go. The lesser we feel restrained. Just allow yourself to soar. And I want you to imagine being up in the sky. See yourself in the sky. Together with your angels. With everyone else in the circle here, and just floating together, allowing this beautiful transmission to take place, and just feel how good it is to let go of everything, to just let yourself be. Not let yourself be tied down to anything. Just to completely let go. And just stay there. Enjoying the bliss. The bliss of just being. At this time, we're going to call upon the flower angels to be with us. It is springtime. It is time for growth, for blossoming. And even if there's snow outside right now, the flowers still have a message for us. The angels are going to speak through those flowers. So as you're floating up in the sky, I want you to look down a little bit and see the flowers below you. And I want you to bring your attention back in the sky to where you are. And just notice flowers magically appearing all around you. Beautiful flowers, beautiful colors, beautiful growth on them. And they're going to open up wide open for you. They're going to have a message for you. One particular flower is going to stand out. And it's going to be the yellow lily. So I want you to imagine a yellow lily. Beautiful yellow flower. And the message this yellow lily has for you is: your money struggles are a thing of the past. Be open to all avenues to receiving, and you'll be provided for in every way. So just hold on to that message. We're going through this virus still. Some things are starting to open slowly but surely. Many of us, though, are in limbo, don't know what's going to happen. Maybe a little bit worried about money and finances. And that's why this flower came forward today, offering you a message of financial healing. The yellow lily wants you to know that's all in the past. Your struggles are in the past. Your fears are in the past. Don't bring them to the present. Allow yourself to be open in this moment in time to receiving, and trust and have faith that you will be provided for in every way, financially and otherwise. All about faith. Doesn't matter if you know how it's going to happen or when. All you need to know is that you will be provided for by your angels, by your guides. You are connected with them at all times. Just trust. You might not see that connection all the time, but know it's there. Feel it there. Trust that it's there. And they will be there. You can call on them for guidance at any time, and they will be there. They will make a way for you. Where there is no way, they will make a way. It's all a test of faith at the moment. So hold on to that faith. Replace fears with unwavering faith and love. Stand in your spiritual authority, knowing that you are enough and you will have enough. You are enough. Everything's going to be okay. And now another flower comes forward. And it's the Protea, sign from heaven. And the message that this flower has for you is, your loved ones in spirit are waving hello at giving you reassurance that you're going to be all right. Another beautiful message. And just allow yourself to receive it, to trust it. You are receiving signs from the flowers, signs all around you, that you are not alone, that your loved ones are with you, supporting you, and reassuring you. Your finances will be taken care of, and everything will be taken care of. The flowers will work together, the angels will work together, for your own good, for your benefit, for the benefit of all. Hold your head up high, stand tall, surround yourself with supportive friends who stand with you, even if it's at a distance. Know that they are with you. Know that they are on your side, just like the angels are on your side. And they're standing behind you, connecting all of us together. And we're all going to get through this together. Open up to that. Open up your inner vision, your inner sight, and see the world through the eyes of the flowers. Open up to the sun. Open up to the light. Protect yourself from the darkness. Shield yourself from that. Stand tall, knowing that you have an inner light within you. You can shine that inner light. There are signs all around us, and you are a sign. The angels are real. You're a sign to others. Trust in that. Trust that others around you serve as angels for you, helping you, guiding you. All different kinds of angels, all different forms. Everything around you, everyone around you is there to help you, is there to support you. There for your growth and development. Signs are everywhere. Just stand up and open up to it and accept them. The last message we mentioned, shielding ourselves. And I guess that's why the bougainvillea flower also stepped forward. Beautiful flower. And the message from that flower is to shield yourself, protect yourself. Invoke protection to bring this situation to a speedy end. So as the other cards mentioned, surround yourself with love and light. Open yourself up to the light. When you feel darkness around you, though, that's your time to take care of yourself, to protect your energies, to hold the light within you, to keep it going strong, and to not allow others, other energies, to change or to lower yours. Keep shining your light and trust that others will be drawn to it. And you can share your light. But you have more than enough to go around. You will never run out. The darkness Darkness can see your light, and it's drawn to your light. So just be careful. Continue to stay in your own light, and surround yourself with more light. Sense the other kinds of energies around you.